Welcome back to the channel. It's the Pure Avenger, guys. Welcome back to another Marvel Future Fight video. Today, we're here with Supernova Nebula. We're going to be taking a look at her with her brand new uniform in World Boss Legend. This video is just sort of a I'm going to do it for fun kind of thing. Nebula really is only meta for ABX. She, of course, takes over that female combat day. But for today's video, I decided to do two videos on her. We're going to test her out in World Boss Legend for fun, and then we'll do the ABX video at a later date. But today, we're going to go ahead and get her awakened. We got her mythic to her uniform to mythic. We got a 160 proc on her with no special stats. A 5-star matching instinct, so that's very nice. Stage 6 of overdrive. Rank 4 combat type enhancement. Max skills, obviously. We got 25 gears with some decent Uru. A couple 4-stars on there, and then the rest is sort of mediocre. But without further ado, let's go ahead and transcend her in 3, 2, 1, bang! There we go. Nebula transcended there with her brand new Supernova Ravager look. I gotta say, I love the way this uniform looks overall. Let's go ahead and transcend her potential as well in 3, 2. Oh, wait, hold on. I gotta get her skill up first. I always forget with the Awakened guys. Boom. There you go. 2 million gold later. And then 3, 2, 1. Bang! Transcended Nebula. So it's gonna be very nice to use an ABX. We might give her a stacked build just because it is ABX. But I'm not quite sure because I do feel like they're trying to cook up and get ready to give us a tier 4 female combat, and I think it's about time. So I'm not 100% sold on tier 4ing her, but we will test her out and see how well she does. So if we go ahead and go into the practice range, we'll actually take a look at her rotation that they give us, because I will not lie to you, I have not looked at it yet. From the videos that I've seen, they just use the one that is given in the practice combo. So let's take a look. It's going to be a 5, 3, and then 4. So that's simple, 5, 3, 4. And then a 6, 5, 3, 4, which kind of, okay, the 6 does linger there, so it's good. Okay, so it's just 5, 3, 4, 6, 5, 3, 4. Pretty simple, no long delays or anything like that. So let's go ahead and put our graphics down to low, and let's go ahead and run into our 3 World Boss Legend runs here today. All right, so we're starting off today's runs, probably the first time ever. We're starting off with none other than Infinity Ultron. We're going to run Stage 9 here. We're running She-Hulk lead and then Valkyrie support, along with the best set of strikers that we have for her. So let's dive right in. So you're probably wondering, why are we starting off with Infinity Ultron? Usually, I start off with Null, then Mephisto, and then Ultron for characters that I'm just sort of having fun with in World Boss Legend when I go to review them. And ooh, that was a juicy 5 bars there from the Transcended rotation. But the reason being is that I don't have a lot of stages of Null and Ultron unlocked to go any higher than 9. So I wanted to start off low with these 9 stages of Ultron and Null, and then work our way up for Mephisto, because we actually do have a lot higher of a stage there available compared to these first two fights. But nonetheless, I mean, this is still a tough fight for her. She's definitely going to get it done. She has the damage just about keeping her alive, because she is very vulnerable. And she can miss a lot of attacks, like right there. So what you want to know about her is that if you're going to use her in World Boss Legend, for whatever reason, if you're having fun or whatever, but what you don't want to know is that her 4 skill is her money maker. But as you saw there, you can also miss a lot of the damage if it's not directly on the boss. You miss out on pretty much all of the damage at that point, because it does not track the boss on its own. It's just kind of stationary. So that kind of sucks. But then also something worth noting is that her heal is on her 3rd skill. So if you need to heal her up, then that 3rd skill is going to be your best friend there, because it's going to get her as much health as she possibly can get. She's fine health-wise. She doesn't have a lot, obviously, compared to an 80 or tier 4, but she has enough that she can stay alive. Again, her only problem is that she can't take those one shots at all, and she doesn't have a V-pad skill or anything else to get out of the 4 skill, and it's not really the most cancelable skill either. That's why they kind of leave it at the end of the rotation, because it gives you all that damage, but you want to sit in it and just let it go. So I feel like if it would have tracked on its own, which kind of makes sense considering it's Yondu's like needle whistle or whatever what you want to call it. I forgot what it's called, to be honest, so sorry if you do know what it's called. Let me know in the comments, actually, if you do know what it's called. I don't remember what it's called, but the problem is it doesn't follow. It doesn't track the enemy. Like, it tracks the enemy, so to speak, but not the entire attack. You know, like, if they move out of the way, you're not hitting them, which is just kind of ridiculous. considering in the movies it literally would track them wherever they go. You know, they weren't, they, all the people he killed with it weren't just standing still, so to speak. You know, they were all moving. So that's what you kind of would have expected out of a skill for her there, that it would have followed the boss as it moves, but unfortunately not. Now, I know with Yondu, when he initially came out, he was the same. It would just be stationary. It only hit them when they're not moving. But you'd think now that a lot of time has passed since Yondu that they would have kind of fixed that with Nebula, but they didn't. It is what it is. It still deals a lot of damage. Just like I said, if you don't, you know, if you don't get right in front of them and in their face, then it doesn't work out. And that's where I feel like she needs a little bit more tankiness to be able to do that. She needs to be able to at least take like one of these one shots and be left with a little bit of health, because right now she would be any of these attacks here, she's dead. She is not surviving these. You know, she's getting taken out, and I'm having to restart the run, which is kind of a problem. So, yeah, that's my sort of take on her as far as what I've tested with her already before this video. And let's see. I'm pretty sure my thoughts are going to stay the same after this video as well. But I guess we'll wait and see. We're almost done with this fight. We've got a minute and 37 seconds left. It's going to be a close one. We have 6 bars left. Again, this is stage 9, so I don't think... I think she can go higher. I just think it'd be a real pain and really hard to be able to pull it off. I mean, it looks like we're going to end up with a minute remaining here. So yeah, that'd be... We could probably go up like 10 more stages. Just be really tough. But there is stage 9 of Ultron done with Nebula with the 160 proc in a minute and 15 seconds. So yeah, who knows? With the 200 proc, she probably can get it done a little faster there too. She got it done in 3 minutes and 45 seconds. She could probably... also get it done faster with the mini rage. We're going to test her with a mini rage in the ABX video. We're actually going to run... Okay, we got to put the team back. We're actually going to run her with the 160 proc and then compare it to the mini rage and see what we're going to want to keep her on for the ABX review. All right, so now that we got our daily world boss legend out of the way, because I completely forgot to do that before starting recording, we can now go ahead and get Null Stage 9 done. So without further ado, let's hop straight on into it. Let's see how this goes. Here we go. Any time now? There you go. Okay, nice. So we're going to go ahead and switch straight to her Pop the Transcended ability, and it'll really give us a gauge of how well we're going to do in this fight and see how fast it is going to take us. And it looks like we're going to breeze right through it. Yep, I thought so. Stage 9, pretty much anyone can clear now with 25% pierce. That can go to Tier 3 and Transcendent, of course. And there you go, 15-second clear of the first phase. So yeah, maybe we should start with Null. But I wanted to switch things up and start with Infinity Ultron for once, because I feel like we always leave him last. You know, he needed a little bit more love and needed to be the beginning of a video instead of the end. Mephisto, we give plenty of love too. We definitely, he's probably our number one played world boss legend, I believe. So putting him last, I do not feel bad at all. Let's go ahead and pop another transcendent rotation here now that we easily dodged that attack. And as you can see, the force skill there kind of stuttered out because he pushed us away. The force skill just stood there. You know, it didn't follow me or the target, it just stood there. And that's kind of her only issue here. Let's see if we can push out of the dragon phase, and not quite. Looks like we could have got that done a little faster if we can push out of the dragon phase, but unfortunately, we got stuck having to play it still. But we'll be able to get out of it immediately and be able to get down to those last 7 bars. So, to be honest, if we didn't get in the dragon phase, we'd probably be finishing the fight right about now at 110. But this is going to slow us down just a little bit, and we're going to get it done probably around 125 is my guess here. Here we go. We're at 115. Let's go ahead and have him run on over. I'm not sure if she can tank it, so I'm in the cage. So I'm going to... Yeah, she can't tank that. So I'm going to pop the co-op, and that should help her be able to tank it. Sure does. And boom, there she goes. Getting stage 9 of Null done. Easy peasy there for Nebula. And she gets it done here in a minute and 27 seconds. And I gotta say, that animation there at the end when she wins a fight is pretty dope. It just goes... the needle goes everywhere and tracks everything and just absolutely obliterates nothing. But it looks really cool. So now we're going into Mephisto, and this is going to be the hard one. It's going to be the probably toughest fight of today. It is stage 25 combat requirement, so it's going to be pretty much the exact same team and some of the same strikers, a couple that got switched up, but they're still going to have the same effects, so it should be no biggie. Let's see if she can get it done. I've only tested the first phase, and she got it done within a minute, so let's see if that stays true here as well in this run. And based off of that, I assume she can get the rest of the run done. Other than that, I haven't played this stage as much as I practiced those last two, so let's see how she does. We're going in completely blind here, basically, and it's going to be pretty interesting to see what she can cook up here. We're going to go ahead and pop the Transcendent Ability, and hopefully that's enough to get us out of this phase. Yes, just barely. He was about to hit the Rage, but we barely were able to actually avoid it, which is awesome, because if not, this run would have been even longer. Now we get to actually see what the damage looks like. So the regular rotation is doing about 4 bars, not too shabby. Our procs are staying pretty consistent and hit a lot better. When we make sure we have all of the rotation up, we're going to have the Transcended rotation here now. Let's see what the damage is looking like. 21 bars down to about 16.5, so that's going to be about 5.5 bars there from the Transcended rotation. Now we're getting hit a lot here, so we need to dodge and go ahead and pop a regular rotation, but unfortunately he decides to go ahead and cancel it completely. Now we have to wait a whole 4 seconds just to get our rotation back. So yeah, this gameplay probably would have been a little bit better with the mini Rage. Who knows, depends what her damage looks like with that. So we'll determine if we do another World Boss Legend video with the mini Rage. But I definitely wanted to test that in ABX because, of course, Rages and mini Rages are kings, the kings of ABX and ABL. So you know we had to, barely squeezed by there. You know we had to involve a mini Rage with Nebula, especially for her being an ABX meta. So yeah, World Boss Legend, we're just doing this for fun. She's by no means a World Boss Legend meta character with all the level 80s available, but she is taking over that one day of ABX, so we're going to have to test that in the next video that we do for her. So we have 2 minutes and 46 seconds remaining to get the final phase of the fight done. We already have 3 bars left, so we are 3 bars down, sorry, so we should be good to go. As long as we keep her alive, some of these attacks now in this phase of the fight can take us out pretty darn easily, so we need to be very careful, especially getting stuck in that 4 skill. That could be the end to this run that has been pretty nice so far, so we don't want that happening whatsoever. Let's go ahead and pop a regular rotation. This is the exact attack right here that we need to dodge no matter what. If we get hit by this, it's over, so good thing we were able to switch there. We're going to go ahead and sneak in a Transcendent Rotation by Valkyrie, switch right back on over to Nebula because that did absolutely nothing. It did maybe a bar, and go ahead and pop Nebula. So at least we know Nebula's Transcendent Rotation does a lot more damage than Valkyrie's. All right, we're going in his first Rage here with 2 minutes left, so still pretty ideal. Now, what's not ideal is having that timestamp right there right as we go to get the second rune there. It's pretty annoying, but regardless, we still get it, and she pops a Transcendent Rotation, bring us down to 13 bars. So at this point of the fight, he's just going back and forth into Rage mode, so we need to be able to go ahead and pop all our rotation and get him out of this little fit that he's having, so that we can actually get it done. And once again, we get one of these time runes right on I don't know what these are called. Time pads, time runes, they're all the same thing, basically. Another one pops up right as we have to hit the next one, so that was unfortunate. But luckily, we were able to still get it done. And we're going to pop the Transcendent Rotation here. I don't think it's going to be enough. I think we need one more at least. So we're going to have to hit this again. And once again, freezes right in front of where I need to go. Like, can we stop that, please? This run is becoming so much longer just because of how many times I've had to dodge those things and wait for them to go away. Like, that is so annoying. But regardless, we go ahead and clear the fight here with 44 seconds remaining at stage 25, meaning she can go a little bit higher, maybe stage 29. If we do a mini Rage review, we might have to test that out. But she gets it done in 4 minutes and 16 seconds. So very nice stuff there from Nebula. Give her a little round of applause there. But yeah, guys, that's pretty much it for the World Boss Legend review. Like I said, just for fun, we're going to be back with our serious video on her for ABX. Test her out with the 160 proc, the mini Rage, maybe a 200 proc. I don't know. Probably just going to do the mini Rage, though, and see how she does. But for now, guys, that'll do it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. And if you did, as always, please consider leaving a like and subscribe to the channel, guys, if you like what you see. But for now, we'll see you in the next one. Peace out.